Change. His ultimate does a lot of damage, as I said. But in saying that, once again, he's going to have to, you know, avoid Ajim because he's going to be quite in the same way that Jhin does it. As soon as he goes into ultimate, Ajim's just...
Look, we're jumping into game number two of day number two of the International Wild Card Qualifiers. And we have a Vel'Koz picked for Plugo on KMV. Interesting, exciting, and potentially awesome.
Yeah, I really am looking forward to this because, as I said, this is...
Jim goes over the wall, but here comes Raze. He's met with the force of 1,000 bars. Bear, he can get the stun off. Not going to happen, though, Ejim.
Julio's starting to ramp up. Love me some Vel'Koz as well.
Stun comes through, hits the wall. There's the snare from Deadly Flourish. Bear doesn't even have to use the shield here, but takes a lot of damage for his troubles. Raze back up to full health, but... There is never an unfortunate trade when you have Subjugate up on Trundle.
Yeah, exactly right. He's just going to continue to use it. Oh, big engage.
This is looking bad. Ejim forced to flash. A great ultimate. Hits two members. That's going to mean the ulti channels from Swiper, but they burst him straight through. Now Raze might be in trouble. A great explosive cast back into the fight. Here comes Spooks. Gets a double knock-up. It might not be enough as Julio Cinto picks up that one. Now
Spooks in trouble.
He's been stunned up. He's walking on the slow. Is able to get to...
Risky call right now. Julio Cinto is still in the area as well as Braum collapsing. They might be able to pick it up, but it's about how much priority they lose on mid lane as well as AD carry now.
But that's just one of the benefits of having Bard. He has abilities that no one else in the game can match. Magical Journey gets them all to safety. I was questioning whether it would be off cooldown as he did use it to get out and defend this tower. It's down below half health now. Raze with that fourth shot now doing extra damage to the towers. Starting to chunk it.
Yeah, so doing a better job here are the Chiefs. Spooks is still on the bottom side of the map, and they are going to force him off.
Ooh, Tempered Fate comes on in through the submarine, comes on. Bear gets stunned up. They might got their attention set onto the Fox. He's got no escape from this one. There's a curtain call onto Bear. A few more attacks should do it. Raze, he's found his mark, but his name is Julio. The shot comes through, gets blocked out by the Fat Man, so Bear gets to live another day,
but it's a huge push. They're going to keep going. He misses a taunt. That's sloppy from Slapper, so Julio Cito will live.
Ooh. Is going to get himself to safety for now, but look at the pressure that the Chiefs are exerting right now. Two turrets for the price of one.
Ejim
they
might
it,
die.
They might have to get themselves out of
He's
here.
Dead.
Oh, the snipe from the tower picks up that one. Julio gets the kill. They lose the top tower in trade. So unfortunately, not being...
Plugo, I assume. Whereas the Chiefs have two huge AP deal, AP and AD dealers. Although mid lane turret now under fire.
Oh, so is the rest of the Chiefs. Spooks, look at the damage. Force to flash, even though the Magical Journey was there. Swiper, he's over the wall. Bear is able to jump to a friendly Swiper. A Swiffer gets the damage out. One more proc, not going to matter. The heal comes through. Now Element in the front line does still have the Subjugate available. The snare comes through. There's the taunt. There's the curtain call looking for the damage. Element, he might have enough to keep himself safe, but Bear now in the front line. Huge damage. Can he burn the Deathfire's touch? Not going to matter. A Swiffer picks it up with the Death Ray.
Yeah, so Swiffer able to dive in and grab that kill. I'm just going to stop. And he's the one that still has it.
It's falling apart at the seams, it seems, for Chaos Latin Gaming. They're not able to find much off that Baron, but you mentioned it's still an element, so they still have a little bit of pressure. You've got to look at the saving graces here. It is going to allow
Julio Stito. So I like the call here, you know, disappear into Fog of War as Baron's falling, spawning, and see if you can get a pick. Looks to be the answer.
Baron down to 6,000 health. Remember, that's only two members taking it.
They took the teleport, however. All of a sudden, the Chiefs just back away. They don't have to do anything here.
And Swiper's, Swiper's still just pushing up that bot lane. Spooks,
they go
for
the
fight. A little bit of trouble. Raze flashes perfectly. Now, Spooks does have the Guardian Angel available. Swiper's gonna come on in, get the taunt. Bear, he's still alive, still body blocking from his team. Spooks back up, and now Fox is in the wrong side of the map, and that's a shutdown coming through from the Trundle. He's doing such great work, a nice double stun.
Ray's got
Swiper.
The
Fox. He got him in the back, he's gonna get another one. Does proc the GA now, Elements, he's running away. Disintegration Ray doing absolutely nothing. Raze is huge, he's running, he's so fast with those crits. Does he have the flash? Tries to go for the far side, but he's just waiting for the side, but he gets it across the wall, but it's not over yet as Chiefs are barreling down, looking for someone. Swiper flashes in, but the Chaos Storm proc's gonna be enough. And one more time around the Baron dance for the Chiefs, maybe, but they're gonna have this time two inhibitors rather than one to help them put on that pressure. And Spooks, he can just straight ult back to the tunnel.
Yeah, exactly right. So they started it up again. This time it looks like they're just gonna be able to burn it down.
No issues.
Yeah, they're just too far away. You really do have to one more time compliment KMV taking INTZ 2:35 minutes, Chiefs 41 minutes, and they're still fighting Rogi. I mean, all it takes is one team fight and you're going to be able to push this one to center.
Tempered Fate available, and the EGM can stall this for as long as he wants.
This is more of a denial pick away from the Chiefs. 4,000, they do stop it, and they got the bear as well.
He's going to block out that Sun. 4,000 health left on the Elder Dragon out. Set it side onto the Chiefs. They should just be able to burst this one down if they choose. Element finally has that Guardian Angel up in the front. Spooks doesn't have his this time around.
Once again, what a really greedy solo split pushing build. But I respect it because they had a win condition of I'm the only person ahead. I need to be able to isolate the 1v1. Credit to the Chiefs for not allowing him to play towards that. But you definitely understood what Element was going for in his build. Wanted to be able to take out Swiper and just continue to push out on turrets. The Chiefs just couldn't.